The 10 days are 9 days you can fast and 10th is haram to fast. 10th is Eid. Yeah, Qurban Eid. So don't fast it. It's haram to fast. But the best ibadah is Qurbani. Salat al-Eid and Qurbani. This is the best ibadah on that day. The 9 days, no doubt, the hadith which is to fast the 9 days, they said, oh, there is not really strong hadith. Yeah, but there is no to say when we said it's not a strong hadith, it doesn't mean it's not allowed. No, ulama said, Allah said, do the best ibadah in these 10 days. And daytime, the best ibadah is what? Fasting. But Arafah day, this is no doubt. This hadith is the best any day ever, Yom Arafah, and if you fast it, you will be forgiven for 2 years, the previous year and the coming year. This is no doubt, right? But because ulama extract this meaning, because they said these 10 days are the best in the daytime, and the best amal, the best deeds you could do in the daytime is fasting, no doubt. Yeah, and if you fast one day, fi sabilillah, nafl, ba'ada Allah baynaka wa bayna jahannam, Allah will make a distance between you and Jahannam for 500 years distance.
If someone makes...
70 years, no?
If someone makes an arrangement that the Udha to be slaughtered back in another part of the world, where more people are in need, what am I... Do I have to avoid cutting my nails and so on and so forth?
Tayyib. The brother said, now what if I send my qurbani to another country to be slaughtered there? Still, I should also keep my nails and my hair. I don't really touch them until I... Yes. Yes, because this is your qurbani. The one who's going to do it, he's going to do it on behalf of you. As if you are at home and you can't slaughter your sheep. So you call the qassab, the butchers, oh, please come to do it. He will do it on behalf of you, even at your home. Yeah? So, yes, as long as you offer the qurbani, you could do it by yourself, or someone will do it on behalf of you. This is your own qurbani in your name, so you don't touch your nails, don't touch your hair. This is number one. Number two, before I leave, I want to remind our brothers here, please listen to this carefully. Usually the brother said, oh, I have aqiqa, I will send my sheep to back home. I will send this qurbani to the needy person. Do I have to wait for the aqiqa or for qurbani to send it to the needy people? If I know they are in need, why can't I send to them all the time?
That's true.
So, sunnah here to do mine. Aqiqa, slaughter your sheep here. You want to send there? Send to them. But this is the sunnah. We have to revive this sunnah among us. Where's your aqiqah? It's not, I send it. So your children never see any aqiqah, never seen any qurbani. They never, where is that teaching the Islam now? Eid day, the qurbani should come home. Children, this is the qurbani. This is the best ibadah. This is a sacrifice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command us. This is the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And you give them the story. This is the education. Again for the aqiqah. Do I have to, the sunnah to disappear from my community? Why? Because I send, I feel the sympathy for my only once a year, an Eid day. So if you know that they are in need, why you provide them only once a year, yaqi? Do your best to help them. But the sunnah should be happen here. Your children should be, but in the same time send. But if you said, oh, I can't do it here, but you told me don't send it there, you miss both now. Send. If every year you send, send. Because no doubt they are in need. Believe me, today I was shocked. I called a country. It is my country, my own country, Egypt. I was really shocked. The sheep there is more expensive than any cow in some other country.
In Syria, I call him
Rawalapai. It's really, hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil. Look how people are really, why is that? They are not really poor. The country is not really poor. But they make it like that. They make people to be poor, enforce them to be poor. No, look at this. They can't afford to get the qurbani. I was really shocked. £200, £250 for one sheep.
What are you talking? $800 in Syria.
So this is again to help. So for the, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy inshaAllah, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ease our the situation for our brothers, help our needy brothers inshaAllah. One here, you done. Okay, yeah. Then he asked first.
Do we have to fast 10 days?
I will repeat it again 3 times. Fast only 9 days. The 10th is Eid al-Adha. You don't fast it. Haram to fast Eid day. You fast 9 days, especially the 9th day, which is Arafah day. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. Yes? 9 days. The cutting the nails, the shaving the hair or trimming the hair is applied for the whole family or for the person who is going to slaughter the qurbani. Ulama said this is for the one who is going to apply this practice the qurbani. But if the family practice it, even better. It's education. You've teach the family, the children who listen, don't do it. Why? Because we need to share our brothers who are Hajj. This is Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's good. But mainly this apply for the person of the qurbani, the one who's going to sacrifice.
Can I be for my family? Because my family going to Hajj, but my family doesn't have money to make the qurbani. Can I be for them for the qurbani?
Yeah, you can help others who don't have, and if they can't afford to do qurbani, can I help them to do it? Of course you can.
As well,
you
have to cut my
nails.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is every person in the house should do qurbani or not? This is a very good question, and listen to this carefully. All other madhahib, they said that one qurbani is enough for the family, for you and whoever, man ta'ul, whoever, they call it dependents. One qurbani is enough for you and all your dependents. Imam Abu Hanifa, he has different opinion. He said everyone has nisab, he should do qurbani. Everyone has enough money, which the nisab, as you know, then he should, could be yourself, your brother, your son, your, if someone like my age, I have a few children, all of them are really, mashallah, the earning, or they have the nisab, they're fine. So in Madhab or Hanifa, everyone should do qurbani, as long as he's earning money and he has the nisab money. The other madhab, they said, no, is enough for you and your dependents. Here now, dependents, again, you can explain it. I don't know if your son is really dependent or not. If he's dependent, khalas, he will be covered. If not, if he's really independent, then he should really do qurbani as well. Yeah?
You know the one, if you have he work, and he have a crib for someone, he pay him every month. He can make the qurbani as well.
What if someone has the debt, but this debt, you call it stable debt. This is again a new issue, new situation. It wasn't before. There is a new way of debt, like someone who he bought a car, bought whatever, but he is paying every month a such amount. Yeah? Installments. This, they call it stable debt. Can I go to Hajj? Can I do qurbani? Can I? Yes, you can do all of that. But if there is a due debt, any due loan you have to pay now, you should pay it first. Before you go to Hajj, before you buy the... Although ulama, subhanAllah, majority of ulama, they said if you don't have money, you are allowed to borrow money to do qurbani. And Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, he said, I hope that Allah will allow him to pay the debt, because he's really keen to apply this sunnah wajib. This is qurbani. Because of the rewards of out of this qurbani, yani subhanallah, each hair you will have a reward of it. And it will come on the day of judgment as any witness for you. Subhanallah, this is a very, very rewardful any amal deeds, inshallah. Anything else? Mashallah, na'am.
There is some organization online, like Islamic Relief, they do a qurbani online to buy and they send it for you in your name. Is it allowed or expected or avoided?
As I said, there is some organization online. What you do, just you pay them, they will buy the qurban, you do the qurban for you. We said it is better to yourself get the qurbani home and show your family, this is our qurbani. Some people said, yeah, but you know, when I buy meat, it's much cheaper. You know, and the meat, you know, ya akhi, qurbani not for the meat. Qurbani itself is sacrifice. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was about to sacrifice his son. Do you think he was about to eat Ismail? Do you think he was about to, oh, Ismail, come, I will slaughter, then I will eat you? No. Is it this? But the point here, I am listening, I am obeying the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sacrifice is the best ibadah. I pay money, I pay. يخي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, طيبوا بها نفسا ما أنفقت الذهب والورق في شيء أحب إلى الله. يعني الورق إنه هو الفضة, the silver, ذهب, the gold, the prophet, because this is the currency at that time, you know. So the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, this is the best way ever to spend your money in قرباني, in عيد day. The best amal to do in Eid day is again qurbani. So you do it not for the meat. Yes, when you do it, one third for masakin, one third gift for your friends and relatives, one third for your family. And the Prophet ﷺ, when he came back home, he asked Aisha, how is our qurbani? He said, Ya Rasulullah, two third is gone. Only third left for us. He said, La ya Aisha, one third will go. And two-thirds will remain for us in the hereafter. Allah. Whatever you give fi sabilillah sadaqah, whatever you give for friends, hadiyah, gifts, this will remain for your rewards in the day of judgment. But whatever you're going to consume, khalas, you consume and finished. You know? So you will need tibu biha nafsa, that means you give, pay the money with the inshirah al-sadr, with the happiness, with the tranquility, with, you know, you are really happy to do this ibadah. I can see this, wallahi, subhanallah, people pay for hajj, £4,000, no problem. I love to go to hajj. But if you want to go to Bangladesh or go to Pakistan, you will ask the travel agent, how much is the ticket? Oh, 500, no, I'm not going to see it. No, I'm looking for, I'll wait until the price. But this hajj, 3,000, 4,000, 4,500, no problem, I will pay. And he's really happy. Why? Because this is ibadah, ta'ah, obedience. He's really happy, he's pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you do qurbani, don't look for all the meat and the blood sacrifice. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِ وَنُسْكِي وَمَحْيَايَ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.
Last one. There have some group said, you know, not like online, like say the brother, like, but same group, you can't be saved.
I didn't finish, sahih. Jazakallah khair. I didn't finish this point, sahih. I'm sorry. Okay. About the organizations. Some organizations, okay, we want this money, I want to do it here and there. I'm not here to promote this organization or that organization. The one, the organization which is really happy and they said, okay, we're going to do this. There is no, any, sometimes you send £100, so about £40 will be administration and £60 for the. Some people said, no, no, we do this only, any, all this is volunteer work and just whatever you pay, this is the money for the qurbani. But again, as I said, try, if you can do it yourself, is even better. If you know some personal contact, also much better. If you have, okay, my families, my relatives, my, okay, I want to send this myself, they will do it. This, but yani, if you want to send with the organization, also is okay, inshallah. And as you, yani, someone asked, again, this related to this, someone said, okay, my name, if it goes there, sometimes they forget the name. Don't worry, they won't slaughter it. Khalas, Allah knows the names. You know, this is a problem, even in Hajj. Some people ask, oh, listen, where is my Qurban has been done? I just always in Hajj Ta'lim, I said, don't ask. Once you give the money, khalas, Allah has accepted this. Even if they haven't done it, they will be asked. But yourself, done your job. Khalas. Yeah? Jazakallah.
Sorry, so the second part of the question. Second part, if, for example, to call a butcher and then he bring it for you, like to the house. Because in this country we can't really buy the sheep.
Okay, this is a bit really sensitive question why you ask me this here, but okay. If someone, and you know that there is someone who is really trustworthy, he can do it on behalf of you, and he is going to do it, khalas, he can do it. Try to do your best. اتقوا الله ما استطعت. فاتقوا الله ما استطعت. You do the best. Try your best.
I just want to ask. No. I have some couple of friend of mine. He said, look, if you can make six, seven people to give you the money, if you have someone in Syria, come buy it and you feed that people. This is okay. Like we are a group, 10, 15 people.
Okay. One
he
sheep.
He asked me. He said to me, we give you the money and I have someone there to buy it for us.
Hello. Same, as I said, if you have a personal contact, yes. And one sheep for one person and his family, one cow for seven people, one camel for seven people as well. Badana, they call it badana. Badana could cover the cow and the camel. The sheep for a person and his family. So you could find seven people to share. You could, one person will do a camel or cow, no problem, what's the problem? Someone said, no, I have to do one sheep because I'm only one, so I have to do one sheep. No, but what if you are a wealthy person? Can I do a camel only for myself? Yes, you can. The Prophet ﷺ, he took 100 camels to Haram. 100 camels, hadi. He slaughtered by himself 63. Then the rest, he asked Ali ibn Abi Talib to do the rest. He didn't say, one is enough for me, not one. One seventh is enough. The Prophet ﷺ, if he called seven people, Abu Bakr, Umar, Osman, six Sahaba, and he is only the seventh, is enough one camel for him. No, he get 100 camels. This is hadiyya, hadif, lillah azza wa jal. So whenever you are able to do more, don't and you show Allah show Allah your generosity and you'll see how Allah will show His generosity. Allah is Kareem. Yeah, if you are wealthy, if you are able to send a cow, not a sheep. Sheep for the one who said, yeah, this is what can I do? But the one who's really able to do a camel or a cow, please help your brothers there, inshallah.
Now,
very good question. The sunnah before Zuhr. Sunnah before Zuhr. Is it four rak'ah in one go or two and two? Ibn Majah, he mentioned in his sunnah that the four only one. Imam Abu Hanifa also four in one go. But other madhahib, they said always the sunnah nafl is two at any time as we pray tarawih. Do we pray four? We pray two like this. Whenever you pray, we pray two like this. Even with two, then one. Yeah, this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you could pray two rak'ah, then taslim, then two rak'ah. Yeah, this is before Zuhur. But if you pray for as Imam Hanifa or Ibn Majah, khalas, you can do. But this is the most strong one, two and two.
Ustaz, is it correct? Because some people pray for rak'ah, but they stay married between after two. I mean, after two rak'ah, they make tahiyyat like a Zuhur, and then start again. Is this correct?
As I said, this is according to Madhab Abu Hanifa. And there is a hadith, I said Ibn Majah mentioned this hadith, this you could pray four rak'ah in one go. This four rak'ah is the same like Zuhr. But the other madhahib and majority and the strong opinion that nafil salah, the Prophet ﷺ used to pray them two in twos. Yeah? Even the three rak'ah witr, he used to make it two and one to be different than Maghrib.
About this story about, I have to ask in English. Some people, when you tell them that the act of fasting these 9 days, they ask me, where do you get that? Did any Sahaba fast these 9 days from 1 to 9? Or there, where do you get all the Prophet himself? Did he fast them? How do I answer them?
Jazakallah, yeah. This is number one. The brother asked about the 9 days. Again, this question comes. The 9 days, he said, there is no evidence. As I said, there is a hadith, but it's not really strong hadith that yes, you could fast the 9 days. The hadith in Bukhari, this is authentic about Arafah day, there is no doubt. But the other days, yes, the brother said, what if the brother said, give me an evidence that the Sahaba used to fast these days. I will give me 2 minutes about this, because this is really important. Some brothers, they think that if there is no an evidence for the 9 days to be fast like that, is going to be bid'ah. Bid'ah is what? If we say that these 9 days is sunnah, you should fast all of them, or the Prophet ﷺ recommend to fast all of them, or to say if you don't fast it's going to be no good, or it's not you are sinful, or this is going to be bid'ah. Secondly, if any ibadah, there is no, they call it any, that's why ulama said nafl ibadah must have similarity to the fard, must have some basics or basis for it. You can't say I am going to pray 5 rak'ah nafl together like this. There is no, let me pray 8 rak'ah in one go. We said no. Okay, let me pray only 1 rak'ah because I don't have time. We said no, because there is no any salah like that. This is not salah. Salah either to be 2 rak'ah or 4 rak'ah. That's it. Only with some of the opinions, you can pray 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, like this, it's fine. But other salah, not. Someone said, let me fast. Let me fast every day up to Asr only. And say, so, you know, it is nice. If you can't fast one full day, fast up to Asr. We said, it's not fasting this. Fasting in Sharia, Fajr to Maghrib. Tayyib, come to this point now. Is there any evidence to say that fasting in these 9 days is not recommended? No. There is dislike to fast Friday, sahih? It is dislike to fast Saturday alone. It is dislike to fast Sunday alone. Taib. What if Friday come Arafah day, like it's coming inshallah? Should I say, no. Prophet ﷺ said it is dislike to fast Friday. We said, no. There is a reason here to fast this day, even if it is Friday, because this is Arafah day, special day. Now, the brothers also, we have same question like this in Ramadan. They said, the Prophet ﷺ, all the time he used to pray Taraweeh only 11 rak'ah. Why you pray 20? Ya akhi. The Prophet ﷺ, he prayed 11 rak'ah, but he didn't say, listen, don't pray more 11 rak'ah. He, and on the top of that, Umar al-Khattab, he prayed 20. Sahaba prayed 20, Tabi'in prayed 20, some of Imam Maliki prayed 36 rak'ah. So what are you going to do? So this is, if there is an evidence to say, don't fast this 9 days, we said, Jazakallah khair, we can't fast. But we are allowed in general, in the Sunnah, the Prophet said that whoever fasts 1 day, fi sabilillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put a distance between him and Jahannam, 70 years distance. This day could be any day. Taib. On the top of that, the Prophet said that these days, the amal in these days are the best amal. Taib, I'm thinking, what is the best amal in the daytime?
Fasting.
Right? So, but again, if you said, but I'm not fasting, don't say, oh, you missed the sunnah, you done this. No doubt the authentic sunnah is 9th of the Hijjah, Arafah day. But we fast the other days because this is the best amal in the daytime. But if one day said, I couldn't fast, no problem, do other good deeds. Why I mention Abu Bakr? Because radiallahu anhu, he gave the best example. For he's looking, any good deeds come up, he do it. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. Whatever, any good deeds come up to you, don't waste, don't hesitate, don't really straight away jump to do it. سَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةِ مَرْبِكُمْ سَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةِ مَرْبِكُمْ. So haste yourself, rush to do the good deeds. Whenever you find any good deeds, straight away do it. إنهم كانوا يسارعون في الخيرات ويدعوننا رغبا ورهبا. Look, Quran said this in Surah Al-Anbiya, Surah Al-Mumin, that those people, they يسارعون في الخيرات. Whenever there is a good deed, they were hasty and rush to do it. This is the competition. وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون. This is the real competition. If you want to compete each other in الخيرات, in the good deeds. So whatever good deeds come up, do it. If you can't fast, do others. Ibadat. Someone said, no, I'm not going to fast. Why? Because I'm going to target. There are some brothers that do this. Said, I'm going to target to memorize 5 juz in these 10 days. There's some people that do this. And he said, I'm going to only fast Arafah. Why? Because I'm going to target to memorize 5 juz. Ya Allah, Bismillah. Some people do memorization, do recitation, do adhkar, do fasting, do sadaqat, do adhkar, istighfar, salat al-rahim. They do all ibadat. Like Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Janazah? Yalla, go for janazah. Miskin? Feed miskin. An ill person? Visit him and dua for him. Daytime? Fast. Do you think when Abu Bakr said, look at this again. When the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "Man asbaha minkum al-yawma sa'ima," who is fasting today? Abu Bakr said, "Me, ya Rasulullah." Other Sahaba didn't say that. Other Sahaba didn't fast. Did the Prophet ﷺ said, "Abu Bakr, why you fast today?"
It was on Monday.
I didn't tell you to fast today.
We don't know.
Huh?
We don't know. It was not Monday.
Nobody mentioned.
We don't know.
If it is Monday, Thursday, the Prophet ﷺ, he would be fasting. Sahaba, they would be fasting. No one knows this. Nobody say, well, Abu Bakr, why did you fast today, Abu Bakr? I didn't tell you.
Saum Dawood,
subhanAllah, day after, every other day. Every other day you can fast. This is open. Every other day. If you are fasting every other day like Dawood, and the day of fasting came Friday, fasted. Sunday, fasted. Saturday, fasted. Because you don't fast it as ta'zeem. You glorify that day like Jews or Christian or no. You fast it because of another reason. Either it is Arafah day, Ashura is coming very soon, inshallah. If any other, yes, you do it. So different reason. That's why when we said there is makruh salah after Asr. But if you come to the mosque after Asr, pray to rak'at Eid al-Masjid. Because there is a reason to pray it. Yeah? So like this. Jazakum Allah khair. Is that time now?
3 minutes.
3 minutes. 2 minutes, yalla.
Another Zuhar Sunnah. Can you pray after for Zuhar Sunnah?
After Zuhar Sunnah, can you pray?
Yeah. Huh? For Zuhar Sunnah.
Okay, yes. The brother said, what if I missed the sunnah before Zuhr? I just only catch farm. Can I pray them after Zuhr? Yes. Rasulullah, he allowed to pray the qada. You pray sunnah, qada after Zuhr. Yes, you can do this. And he did it. One of the explanation that when they said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he prayed for rak'ah and asr time, you know, although this time is not, they said because he missed the sunnah after Jum'ah. He after Salat Jum'ah, lots of people came to him, then he didn't pray the sunnah after Jum'ah, then that's why he prayed them there. Hajj, since and ulama said that Hajj, it was even before Adam. The angels used to do Hajj up to now in Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur. In the top of Kaaba, if you go to the heaven straight, you will find Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur. And subhanAllah, the one who built the Kaaba here is next to the Bayt Al-Ma'mur up there. Ibrahim alayhi salam. When the Prophet went for Isra al-Mi'raj, he found Ibrahim alayhi salam sitting there and lean on the Bayt al-Ma'mur. And he said, this Bayt al-Ma'mur, every day 70,000 angels come to this Bayt al-Ma'mur, do tawaf there and leave. And they don't come again up to the Day of Judgment. See now how many angels now. You can't really count. Every day 70,000 come to do tawaf there like Hajj and leave, and another every day. So this is Bayt al-Ma'mur. So the angels doing Hajj, prophets, all of them, and even since Ibrahim alayhi salam asked people to do Hajj, everyone is to do Hajj. All prophets before the, so they inherit this. But what they used to do, they used to respect haram. That's why they do 3 months haram for people to go to Hajj. But their intention is what? Yes, some of them, they have the intention. That's why they call it Hatim. There, and they used to know that there's a sacred place, and no one can do any sin there, no one can harm anyone there. But majority of them, they go there to show off. To show off, they say, oh, we are, and feed Hujjaj. They go there to feed them. Said, yeah, you know, we are the people who feed people. And if there is a war between them, if anyone killed these two, said, you know, because I'm rich man, I can pay the ransom for this man. That's to show off. Yeah? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after Islam, He purified subhanahu wa ta'ala this and taught Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Quran, as we mentioned, the verses, how to go Hajj with the perfect intention and how to perform Hajj as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the wisdom behind this, as I said, it was just to show off. But they inherit that everyone should go to Hajj there for different intentions.